The main storage facilities were Dero, Tua, and Gago, all of the granary family. Crops like unprocessed millet, sorghum, maize, and dried vegetables could be stored in the granary built in the compound, while simsim, beans, pigeon peas, and green gram, among other grains, could be stored in the tour constructed inside the house. However, due to modernization and moral decay, the good culture practice is now slowly dying.
The way we used to store our foods in general, in Lao culture, there is what we call dero. In our culture, that is the granary. We also have what we call goga. Goga also was part of what we used to keep our food from. In every family that has elders, you'll find that they do have goga in their home. And that is one of the reasons why we used not to lack what to eat. We could not even be lacking what to plant, because in every family you find that there are food crops. There are those that are stored for food, then there are those ones that are stored as the grains and the rest.
In the past, the Lao people used to keep their foodstuff in granaries. And everything was okay. And in those days, there was no element of this theft, thuggery, and misconduct. But nowadays, people fear if they put their food items in those granaries, it would be very, very easy for the thieves to just go and get the foodstuff in any time they want. So it is now a bit tricky. So even in such houses now, you cannot keep your foodstuff there. They can even ban it if you are not careful.
Sylvia Akelo, 62, from Akura in Alepton district, says the cultural practice is now being phased out due to poor harvests and increased incidences of theft. I used the granary for storing my foodstuff. When I harvest millet, I make sure it's dry and store it in the granary. However, many people have abandoned this storage practice because of poor yields. Nowadays, I keep most of my foodstuff in the house. I keep maize in the house and unthreshed millet in the granary. Edward Odongo, also from Akura, says he uses dero for storing millet, sorghum, and other grains. He has explained why many people don't use this storage method anymore. Some people have not learned the proper way to use it, and many are insecure due to increased theft. It is very easy for thieves to open the dero and steal our grains. The construction process is also not easy. We use dero to store millet, sorghum, and other types of seeds to be preserved for planting for the next season. Many people have, however, deviated from the culture storage practice, saying it's outdated, and these are some of the reasons causing hunger. In a bid to revive and promote traditional ways of food storage in Lango Heritage Center, has displayed some of the storage systems. This meant to educate, sensitize masses on storage and preservation of foodstuff.
It has a cover. All of the chickens, all the mother hen, the cock, the chicks, all...
John Cavey, the business manager of Lango Heritage Center, explains the different Lango storage systems and how they are used.
The center is... an idea to promote cultural tourism in Uganda. We are doing our best to make sure that our tourism outstands. And so one of the areas we know we can outstand is promoting our culture. Because culture is what makes you unique. Culture is what God has given us to make us outstand, to be different. You know, our language, our food, our way of life, and a lot more. You know, so here in Lango Heritage Center, we have tried to project the culture of the Lango people. Lango people are one of the biggest tribes in northern Uganda here, occupying about quite a large chunk of space here, 9 districts altogether.
He further explains that inadequate post-harvest storage exposes crops to contamination by microorganisms, chemicals, excessive moisture, fluctuating temperatures, and mechanical damage. Hudson Apunyu for the news.